The development of the mineral sector has raised contentious issues about land value and fair resettlement packages. Landowners have sought clarity on how minerals in their land belong to the government.
The new law is expected to address critical challenges and increase revenue from the mineral sector. It introduces a comprehensive, stable, transparent, efficient, and effective legal and regulatory framework to govern the mining subsector.
The Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabirwa, has addressed the concerns, highlighting that, according to the new Mining and Mineral Act of 2022, sharing of mineral royalties has improved. She says the central government will get a 70% share, district local governments will get 15% share, sub-counties and town councils 10%, landowners and lawful occupants of land subject to mineral rights will benefit 5%.
There are minerals that facilitate the agriculture sector. Vermiculite, for example, is one of those. Phosphates can also help us get fertilizers. So we want that downstream linkage, you know, so that we can really boost the economic potential of this country, and we do have great potential.
To further unlock the mineral subsector potential to spur the country's economic development and transformation, the government is set to establish the country's national mining company to manage commercial interests in strategic minerals.
We'll enhance infrastructure development such as power, logistics, communication, water, skills, and technology development.
The minister maintained that mineral licensing processes and transactions will be conducted online to ensure transparency and accountability in minerals. Currently, gold targets have been identified in several parts of the country, including Buhwejo, Mubende, Namayingo, Karamoja, and Zombo districts. Tough penalties, sanctions, and fines, however, await the illegal miners.
Illegal mining, including conducting prospecting, exploration, and mining without a mineral right or mining license.
Small-scale miners, artisanal miners, medium-scale miners, and large-scale miners can now all acquire mining licenses or permits.
To align with the new law, so the ministry has ensured that all the mineral licensing processes and transactions are conducted online to ensure transparency and accountability in the mineral subsector.
On the other hand, over 500 million tons of rare earth elements have been estimated in eastern Uganda. The reserves of high-quality vermiculite at Namakara in Manafa district have subsequently increased from 5 million tons to current 54.9 million tons. Report by Jeliad Namuwaya for the news.